Hello dear students and good evening to all of you. I welcome you all to the second session of our live classes and I hope all of you have enjoyed our first session. So students, let's start today with a new chapter of class 8th geography. As I have explained you in the previous video only that I will continue the 6th chapter of geography. The chapter is major crops and case studies. Today I am providing you the first half part of this chapter, okay, and the next half I will provide you in the next video. So students, as we have learned about agriculture in the first or in the fifth chapter, okay, in this chapter we are going to learn about some major crops that are grown all over the world, okay. We will also learn about the cropping pattern, that how many crop seasons are there in a year, as well as we will also learn about that how many types of crops are there, okay. Crops are divided into different types on the basis of their consumption. How people are utilizing the crops, that is on the basis of that only, crops are divided into many parts, okay. So let's begin our chapter with the types of crops, okay. Firstly, we are going to learn about types of crop. So first is food crops, okay. Food crops means the crops that we use or consume in form of food, like grains, pulses, okay. So if, for example, what are the food crops? Rice, wheat, millet, maize, pulses, and there are many more, oil seeds, spices, all these are the food crops. The next one is beverage crops. Beverage crops means the crops that we use to consume in drinking form, okay. The crops that we use to consume in form of drinking, that is beverage crops, and in that we are going to learn about tea, coffee and sugarcane. The next is fiber crops. I hope all of you are aware about the fiber crops. What are fiber crops? Okay, fiber crops from which we get thread or from which we get fibers, okay. So in this we are going to learn about jute and cotton, and the next is cash crops. So students, there are some beverage crops or fiber crops that are considered as cash crops also. Cash crops means the crops that are grown for the commercial purpose to sell it in the market, and in exchange of it we get money. So in cash crops there is jute also, cotton also, rubber, tea and coffee. Sugarcane is also a cash crop. So in this chapter we are going to learn about all these crops we will learn about, and we will also learn about that what are the climatic conditions that are necessary for the growing of these crops, and we will also learn that what are the which places or which country or which state of India is leading producers of these crops, okay. So before starting this let's start with cropping pattern. Now what is cropping pattern? Cropping pattern means there is 1 year, and in that 1 year, okay, how farmers grow crops in their field, that is only the cropping pattern. If I'll talk about our country India, in our country our farmers, or we follow 3 cropping seasons, okay. The first is Rabi, as we are knowing that a year has 12 months, okay, and India is a diverse nation with physical elements also, and due to that only the climatic conditions of India also changes throughout the year. According to that only, we are having 3 seasons according to the change in seasons, okay. Rabi, Kharif and Zaid. We are going to learn about all the 3 seasons. We will learn about Rabi, why this season is Rabi, Kharif and Zaid. Let's start with the Rabi crops, and let's have a look which type of crops are considered as Rabi crops, okay. So the crops that are grown or that are sown in winters from October to December, that means the winter crops are known as Rabi crops, okay. These crops are sown from October to December and harvested in summers, that is between April to June. Like wheat is a type of Rabi crop, okay. Now which are the states where these types of or Rabi crops are majorly grown in India? That is north and northwestern parts of India, like Punjab, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Jammu Kashmir and Uttarakhand, okay. So Rabi crops are the winter crops that are sown in winters, okay, and harvested in April or June, or we can say summers. Now let's see what are the, take some examples of Rabi crops, okay? Crops such as wheat, barley, peas, gram, mustard, okay? These are the crops that are Rabi crops. Now we will talk about the Kharif crops, okay? What are the Kharif crops? Let's have a look. So the crops that are sown with the onset of monsoon, that means as the monsoon started in India, so monsoon started between June to July, okay? These crops are sown during monsoon seasons and harvested during September, October, or we will also take November, okay? Like rice, or we can say paddy, okay? This is the crop that is considered as Kharif crop because it is harvested, it is sown during the monsoon seasons, then July, June or July, okay? And it is harvested in September. Now there are some crops like paddy, maize, jowar, bajra, all these are the Kharif crops. And Kharif crops are basically grown in Assam, West Bengal, coastal regions as well as Uttar Pradesh. So let's have a look what are some of the examples of Kharif crops. Crops such as paddy, okay, maize, this is millet, okay, this is millet. Next is, this is maize, third picture is of maize. Nextly we are going to see, this is cotton plant, this is groundnut, this is soybean plant, and this is also bajra, okay, this is also a variety of millet. So these are the crops, or we can say Kharif crops, okay. Now let's have a look on the next one, Zaid crops. So Zaid season comes between the Kharif season and between the first one. Let's see, Zaid is short season between Rabi and Kharif season. Remember, first is Rabi, then Zaid, and then Kharif, okay. During the summer months, crops produced are watermelon, muskmelon, cucumber, vegetables, and fodder crops. Crops are basically grown in the Zaid season, okay. So Zaid season is a very short season, it is in between Rabi and Kharif, and basically vegetables and fodder crops are grown during this season. So this is all about the cropping pattern that we follow in India. We follow three cropping pattern in India, or in one year we grow three different seasonal crops, that is Rabi, Zaid and Kharif. I hope cropping pattern is clear to you and types of crop is also clear to you. Now we are going to learn about some major crops of India, and we will also take reference of the world. So firstly we are going to talk about rice. If I'll talk about rice, all of you are knowing that rice is the most staple food of India. Staple means the important food, not only of India, many people all over the world consume rice as staple food, okay. It is the, we can say that it is the most important food crop of the world, okay. So rice is also known as paddy. Rice is known as paddy when it is in the field, the form when it is cleared, and we consume it in the form of rice, okay. So it is a food crop. Approximately 50% of the total world population consume rice as staple food, that means as chief food, main food. As you can see, this is paddy, okay, and this is rice, okay. Now let's see what are the conditions for the growth of rice, okay. What are the environmental conditions in which rice can grow better? Students, this is most important. You have to remember that which crop can grow good in which type of environmental condition. Someone asked me yesterday, what are environmental condition? So environmental condition means rainfall, soil, land, okay, temperature, climatic conditions, all these are the environmental conditions. So let's see the first, which type of soil is good for the cultivation of rice? Clay soil, as well as loamy, as well as alluvial. That means rice needs a very fertile soil that can retain water in it, jo khud mein pani rok sake, theek hai. The next is land, which type of land is good for the cultivation of rice? So that is deltaic region and the flood plains, the plains that are very fertile, okay. Next we will see what kind of temperature is necessary. So minimum 20 degrees Celsius and maximum 40 degrees Celsius. As rice is a Kharif crop, okay, so Kharif crops are grown in the monsoon season. So at that time the temperature is between 20 to 40 degrees Celsius only. Now which type of land, okay, if we'll talk about the rainfall, as we are knowing that rice is a crop that needs more rainfall, okay, it needs more rainfall. So this rainfall must be more than 100 centimeter. Okay, that is why this crop is grown during the monsoon when there is good rainfall. Now we are going to see area of production. That means which countries all over the world are the producers of rice and which states of India are the producers of rice. Now if we will talk about all over world, so China is the leading producer of rice. Okay, China is the leading producer of rice, and after China it is India. So the second largest producer of rice is India. Okay, now again Japan, Bangladesh, these are also the main rice producing countries, and after this Egypt, Sri Lanka, Indonesia, Italy, Brazil, Turkey, Spain, France, USA, all these are the good producers of rice. Now if we will talk about India, in India the state West Bengal is the leading producer of rice. Okay, and after West Bengal, it is Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, Tamil Nadu, Bihar, Chhattisgarh, Orissa, Assam and Karnataka. So these are the states of India that are the good producers of rice, and West Bengal is the leading producer. If we will talk about all over the world, so it is China. Okay, now let's come to our next topic, and next we are going to discuss about wheat. All of us are very well familiar about wheat. Wheat is the staple food of us. Everyone consumes wheat, and all of us are knowing that wheat is only changes to flour that we consume in the form of bread and chapatis. Now nextly, wheat is the second most popular staple food, that is main food in the world. Okay, next is, because there are some countries where wheat production is very less. Okay, next is, it is also considered more nutritious than rice. Wheat is bit nutritious than rice in comparison to wheat. Rice, wheat gives more energy to you. Wheat grain is powdered, refined and made into flour. As all of us are knowing that we do not consume wheat, we consume flour. Okay, so this is all about wheat. Wheat is the second most popular staple food in all over the world. Now let's talk about the conditions for the growth of wheat. What are the necessary conditions in which wheat can grow better? Okay, soil kaisi honi chahiye? Well-drained loamy soil should be there. Which type of land? Undulating plains that allow drainage of soil. Now what is the meaning of undulating land? So students, there are some wave-like structure you are knowing now. So the land that is not exactly plain, the land that is in wave-like structure, that is good for the growing of wheat. Next, which, how much temperature is needed? So as we are knowing that wheat is a winter crop, so it needs less temperature. So in cool climate, it will grow good. But as the wheat ripened up, when the crop prepares, at that time it needs a bright sunshine, okay, to ripening. For ripening, it needs bright sunshine. That is why it is cut during summers. So cool climate, 10 degrees Celsius at the time of sowing, when it is sowing, when the seeds are sown in the fields, farms, at that time it needs 10 degrees Celsius, and at the time of ripening it needs approximately 15 to 20 degrees Celsius of temperature. So I hope it is clear to you. What rainfall? Rainfall it needs very less, because heavy rainfall destroys the crops. Okay, so it needs average rainfall up to 40 to 75 centimeter of rain. It is an important food crop for humans as well as for animals also. Now how it is a food crop or a fodder for animals? Because its stalk is fed to cattle. That means the covering of maize is used as food for the cattle. Okay, and maize is also used for making cornflakes, for making starch, for making beer, as well as for making alcohol also. Okay, so as you can see, this is maize. Okay, and the covering of maize is used as fodder for the animals. So maize is also known as corn. It is originated in Central America. Okay, it is the most widely used or consumed crop all over the world. Nextly, we are going to see what are the growing conditions for the maize. So which type of soil? Well-drained loamy soil. About soil you have learned in SST third chapter. About soil you have learned in science also. Okay, so well-drained loamy soil and alluvial, as well as it grow better in red soil also. Which type of land? So plateau land and undulating plains, as well as on hilly areas also we can grow maize. Maize can grow on hilly areas also. Okay, which type of temperature? So temperature is average. Bahut high temperature nahi chahiye. 21 degree Celsius to 27 degree Celsius. That is why it is grown during winters, I think. Okay, next is rainfall. Okay, rainfall is also average. That is up to 50 to 80 degree Celsius. So during the season of this one, this season, the monsoon season, when it is ending, is I think this is the time for the maize production. This time only we get corn to eat now. So this is the ideal condition for the growth of maize. Now let's talk about the next areas of production. So which country is the leading producer of maize? As we are knowing, it is originated from Central America. So it is quite obvious that USA is only the leading producer of maize. I have written one above US. Okay. Now Central America, South America, South Africa, China, India, Mexico and Indonesia are also the major producers of maize. If we will talk about India, so in India, Karnataka is the largest producer of maize. Now, hilly areas of Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir, Uttar Pradesh, Punjab, Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Eastern Rajasthan, they are also the leading producers of maize. That means India also produces a good amount of maize. Okay, now next crop is millets. Students, why it is written here millets? Because there are many crops that are considered as millets that I will explain you. So what is millet? Millets are a group of coarse grains. Okay, varieties of grains are there that are considered as millet. That is jowar, bajra and ragi. So students, jowar, bajra and ragi are the crops that are used as staple food in the places where rice as well as wheat are not grown. Okay, there are some places in the world where wheat and rice are not available. The people of those places use jowar, bajra and ragi as the staple grains. Okay, millets are used both as food as well as fodder crops. So jowar, bajra are also used to feed the cattle. You will ask your grandparents, they will tell you that they used to give jowar as to the animals also. Okay, so millet is also used as food as well as fodder crops. If someone asks you about millets, and one more name is there, sorghum. I will explain you what is sorghum and millet. So if someone asks you what are millets, you will say it is a group of coarse grain. Coarse means finely grained. Okay, jowar, bajra and ragi. Okay, now next we will see millets are consumed especially in the drier parts. Drier means in the arid regions where there is very less rainfall. Okay, so these are the places where we can grow millets, where rice and wheat cannot be grown. Next, jo small grains hote hain, that are millets, or they are the grains that are largely grained, that are sorghum. It is named by two names, millets and sorghum. Jo large grain hai, that is sorghum, that is small grain, that is millets. Okay, now let's have a look. This crop is the crop of jowar. Okay, and as you can see, this is jowar grain. Okay, so this is what? Jowar. Now next picture I am going to show you. The next picture belongs to bajra. These are the crops of bajra and these are bajra. Okay, so these are also grains. People used to make chapatis and bread also with it. Okay, now next crop I am going to show you, and the next crop is ragi. This is the crop of ragi and this is ragi. Very small grain. Okay, so these are the millets. I hope it is clear to you, sorghum, millet, ragi, jowar and bajra. Now let's see what are the places, what are the ideal conditions for the growth of millets. Soil kaisi honi chahiye? Light sandy soil, because it can grow in drier areas also where there is very less rainfall. Soil can be red, yellow as well as loamy also. Temperature is average 25 to 30 degree Celsius. Rainfall 40 to 50 centimeter of rainfall. And it can grow well in arid regions, the dry regions also. Now let's talk about the areas of production. So if we will talk about the world, India is the leading producer of millets. In India, varieties of millets are available and all the three millets, jowar, bajra and ragi, can be grown in India. Nigeria, Niger, China, Southeast Asia are the major producers, as well as US, Argentina and Russia are the minor producers. Let's talk about India. In India, Madhya Pradesh is the largest producer of millets, and after Madhya Pradesh, Deccan Plateau, Rajasthan, Gujarat, and Maharashtra are also the states where millets can be grown. Now let's talk about the next one, sugarcane. Okay, so as I have explained you, sugarcane is a beverage crop also. Okay, we consume sugarcane juice na, and sugarcane is cash crop also. Cash crops means we utilize it as the commercial purpose. Sugarcane is used for manufacturing sugar as well as jaggery, you all are knowing. And which state of India is the leading producer of sugarcane? Yes, Uttar Pradesh is the leading producer of sugarcane. Let's talk about sugarcane now. Sugarcane is also used as food, as cash crop also. Okay, we can use it as in the form of cash crop as well as beverage crop, and food crop we cannot say. Beverage is okay. Beverage is also considered as food crop. Okay, we consume its juice. It is a kind of tall grass with a thick stem and grows to height of 3 meters or more. I hope, or I think that all of you have seen at least sugarcane you have seen in the farms. Okay, so the waste of sugarcane is known as bagasse. The waste of sugarcane is known as bagasse. Have you seen or have you ever consumed the juice of sugarcane? Okay. So the residue that is left after the juice, that is only known as bagasse. I will show you the picture of bagasse also. The bagasse of the sugarcane is used for feeding the cattle as well as for making papers also. Now these days bagasse paper are very famous. Now you can see this is the picture of sugarcane. It is a tall grass. Sugarcane is considered as grass, and this is the juice of sugarcane. As sugarcane juice is extracted, and this juice is used for manufacturing what? For manufacturing jaggery and sugar. So I hope it is clear to you about sugarcane. Let's talk about the ideal conditions for the growth of sugarcane. Okay. So what are the ideal conditions? This is bagasse. Have you seen bagasse? This is only the bagasse. When we extract its juice, the residue is only the bagasse. It is used for making paper. Now let's see ideal conditions for the growth of sugarcane. Soil kaisi honi chahiye? Loamy, alluvial, black, and even laterite soil are also suitable. That means sugarcane can be grown in any soil. Okay? What kind of temperature? Average 20 to 27 degrees Celsius. Now next, rainfall. It need a good rainfall up to 70 centimeter to 120 centimeter of rainfall is good for sugarcane growth. Which type of land? It grows well in plains. Let's talk about area of production. Okay, if we will talk about world, so Brazil is the leading producer of sugarcane. After that, Cuba, then India, China, Thailand, Mexico, Pakistan. These are the major producers of sugarcane. Cuba is, I think, also known as sugar bowl. Okay. So, because sugar is produced more there. So, first is Brazil, then Cuba is there. If we will talk about India, so in India, Uttar Pradesh is the leading producer of sugarcane. Then Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh and Gujarat. Now, let's see the next crop, what we are going to learn. As the picture, it is clear, tea. We are going to learn about tea. Tea is a beverage crop. We use it into drink, okay? So tea is basically a plant, a bushy plant from which we get the tea leaves, and that leaves is only used as tea. Okay. So from where we get tea, that we have learned in class 7. Firstly, who bring tea? That is China. Okay. So tea is a popular and cheap beverage crop grown on plantations. As we have learned in the previous chapter only, that plantation agriculture, in which single crop is grown on large scale for commercial purpose, in that tea is also grown. So tea is a very popular in every home. The morning starts with tea, okay? And whenever a guest comes to you, you always serve tea. So just imagine, tea is very important, okay? And it is a very popular and as well as cheap also, okay? There are some expensive tea also, okay? There are some leaves. The leaves, they used to dry the leaves, and those leaves are very expensive, okay? But we can get, that is refined. The good qualities are very expensive. Then the next, okay? The tea that we are consuming, दैट इज़ अ वेरी चीप क्वालिटी. ओके द फर्स्ट ए ग्रेड टी इज एक्सपेंसिव, इट इज़ वेरी एक्सपेंसिव. ओके सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट, इट इज़ ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम द लीव्स ऑफ एन एवरग्रीन बुश. हैव यू सीन द टी प्लांट्स? आई थिंक सम ऑफ यू हैव सीन. हैव यू सीन इट इन पिक्चर्स? सो ऑल द टाइम द टी प्लांट्स आर ग्रीन एंड यू विल नॉट इमेजिन अ प्लांट गिव्स लीव्स फॉर कंटिन्यूअसली 2 to 3 years. सेम प्लांट इज यूज, द पीपल यूज टू प्लक देयर लीव्स एंड अगेन दैट ग्रोज. ओके एंड दैट कंटिन्यूज फॉर 2-3 years. सेम प्लांट गिव्स द टी लीव्स. द टी बुश यील्ड्स लीव्स ओनली इन द थर्ड ईयर. टू लीव्स एंड अ बड आर प्लक्ड फ्रॉम ईच स्टेम टू मेक टी. ठीक है, दीज आर द टी लीव्स, दिस इज टी एंड दिस इज द टी दैट वी कंज्यूम इन द फॉर्म ऑफ बीवरेज. नाउ लेट्स सी द आइडियल कंडीशंस फॉर द ग्रोथ ऑफ टी. एज वी आर नोइंग टेरेस फार्मिंग इज गुड फॉर द कल्टिवेशन ऑफ टी. सॉइल की बात करेंगे तो एसिडिक वेल ड्रेन्ड लोमी सॉइल विद हाई डिग्री ऑफ फर्टिलिटी. सॉइल शुड बी वेरी फर्टाइल फॉर द ग्रोथ ऑफ टी. Temperature is average, approximately 25 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius. Now, which type of rainfall? Climate should be humid climate. Okay, it needs a very good rainfall. Okay, humid climate with rainfall of over 100 centimeter to 250 centimeter. Tea as well as coffee. Both of these plants need a very good rainfall for the cultivation. Now, which type of land? Terraced hill slopes. As we are knowing, terrace farming is only practiced for the cultivation of tea. So, terraced hill slopes are very good for the cultivation of tea. So, students, if we will talk about tea crop, so as we are knowing that it requires a large number of laborers. I have explained you in the previous chapter only. The hat in this type of plantation or in this type of agriculture, tea production may mechanized work is very less. Okay, human labor is more. Laborers are used to pick the tender leaves. It is usually done by women. Okay, so let's talk about the area of production. If we will talk about area of production, China is the leading producer of tea all over the world. Then India, Sri Lanka dominate world tea production. There are some other countries like Japan, Indonesia, Kenya and Bangladesh are other major producers of tea. Now, if India ki baat karenge, to Assam is the leading producer of tea. Then Darjeeling are known for tea throughout the world. The Nilgiri Hills and the past part of Western Ghats. Okay, Western Ghats means Maharashtra and all. The Western Ghats, near these ghats, also tea grows good. Okay, so these are the mainly Assam and Darjeeling are the leading producers of tea in India. Now let's talk about the next crop. We are going to talk about coffee. Can you see in the picture? This is the coffee seeds, beans we can say, coffee beans. Now let's talk about coffee. The coffee plant was discovered growing wild. Coffee plant was growing wild only. Okay, a person discovered it in Kaffa in Ethiopia. So coffee is discovered in Ethiopia. It is a favorite beverage around the world. Most of you also like coffee in comparison to tea. There are most people, those who prefer coffee in comparison to tea. And there are variety of coffee available all over the world. Okay. Different kinds people use to prepare coffee with different ways. Coffee powder is obtained by grinding roasted coffee beans. These are the coffee beans. They are not prepared to be. Okay. Now these are the roasted coffee beans. And these are the, this is the grinded form. Okay, powdered form is used for making the coffee. Now, if we will talk about the area of growth or the conditions of growth, in condition of growth, rich porous soil is important. And even the places where volcanic eruptions took place, na, that volcanic soil is also very ideal for the cultivation of coffee. Okay, temperature 14 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius. Temperature, moderate temperature it needs. Okay, but there should not be, because temperature is very less, 14 degrees Celsius. Okay, it doesn't mean that it should be a frosty winter, that the plants are very delicate now, they should not melt. Okay, rainfall is approximately 100 centimeter to 250 centimeter. As I have explained you, tea and coffee needs a very good rainfall. Tea, coffee and paddy needs a very, very good rainfall. Okay, land, undulating highlands, slopes and plateaus. This also grows on slopy areas also, okay? Hilly areas only. Now let's talk about the area of production. If we will talk about the area of production, so Brazil is the leading producer of coffee. Next, Colombia, Jamaica, Western and Eastern Africa, Central America and Indonesia are the major producers of coffee, and Brazil is the leading one. If we'll talk about India, so in India, Eastern and Western Ghats are mountainous na. So Eastern and Western Ghats matlab kya hua? In Southern Peninsula na, Southern Peninsula, in which the eastern side is also mountainous and western side is also mountainous. In like Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Karnataka, all these regions, okay? These are Eastern and Western Ghats. And Karnataka is the leading producer of coffee in India, then Kerala and Tamil Nadu. In India, coffee is very less produced, but Karnataka is the leading producer. So I hope this much is clear to all of you. I have explained this much. Now we are only left with the fiber crops. I will explain you the fiber crops in the next. About jute and cotton, we will learn in the next video. Okay? And I will also explain you about agricultural development, and we will also have a case study. Okay? That what is the difference between India and the other country farming. Okay? So we will learn about all these in the next part. So thank you, students. I hope all of you are able to understand the lesson.